An overnight fire in West Baltimore has left one man dead. Officials say the fire station closest to the home was closed overnight due to budget cuts. Good afternoon. I'm Mindy Becerra. This fire comes 2 days after the announcement of more station closures in the new year. Started around 3 o'clock this morning in the 3100 block of West Prestman Street, raising questions about how quickly firefighters were able to respond. 11 News reporter Kate Amara live at the fire department headquarters with the latest. Kate.
Mindy, I just got off the phone with a spokesperson for the Baltimore City Fire Department just a few minutes ago, and he just released some new information about this fatal fire to me. He identified the victims. A 76-year-old man identified as Sam Davis was the person killed in the fire. A 76-year-old woman, Mamie Davis, was injured in that fire, and their daughter, Fran Wilder, who was inside the home at the time, did manage to escape without any injuries. I'm told the cause of this fire remains under investigation. It caused a total of $20,000 worth of damage. And we're told there were two smoke alarms in the home too early to tell if they were working. This fire, as you mentioned, Mindy, comes the same week as the fire chief announced a controversial new way to make up for budget cuts. Instead of rotating closures, the chief announced there would be two rotating fire company closures and three permanent closures. The fire company closest to this home was closed overnight. About an hour ago, we asked Chief Clark if those closures had an impact on response, and here's what he said.
I will say the truck 18, which was the closest truck to this address, was one of the rotating closures last night, and that engine 20, with first in engine, had just been sent on a, turned out, a false alarm east of the station about a mile, along with a bunch of other companies. And so we had a couple of events that contributed to a little bit of a delay in us getting to the fire. But preliminarily, just looking at the run reports, we did get to the fire within the time we wanted to get to it.
The chief adds Baltimore City still has some of the best response times in the nation. Reporting live from Fire Department Headquarters, I'm Kate Amara, WBAL-TV 11 News.